Mindfulness does have a very strong basis in the Jewish approach. You mentioned before about the idea of creation at every moment. And when you think about the dynamic of time, as in this moment being a moment in which God is creating the entire universe from scratch, including all of history and all of the future, so that this slice of time, this moment, is all that exists from that perspective. That's all that ever existed and all that will ever exist. So this perspective is a valid one from a Jewish perspective. What concerns me a little bit is more the objectives of the Buddhist objectives as to why mindfulness practice plays such a central role. Whereas in the Buddhist approach, the ideal is to come to be at peace with reality as it is. It's to be at peace with things as they are. It's about realization, where you realize the perfection of everything as it is. In Judaism, while it may appear that our philosophy is somewhat similar to that, that ultimately God designed a perfect world, but there's another component to that as well, and that is, people commonly refer to it as tikkun olam, that God placed us here with a mission. That it's not enough for us to be at peace with the world as it is, but rather we have a certain mission to accomplish, something to achieve in this world, and therefore Judaism has a particular ratio of how to divide the being and becoming. The being, which is in some ways similar to the Buddhist ideology, and the becoming, in other words, our working towards a better world and a better ideal, more commonly known as Shabbat, where there's a ratio of 6 to 1, where God tells us 6 days you should work, and the idea behind it, the philosophy behind it being that we're here to accomplish, we're here to make this world a better place. So then we're focused on what we're doing, on what we're becoming, on what we're making of our world. Whereas Shabbat is our one day of the week where we focus on being. We focus on that sense of identity, how our identity really transcends that which we do. We really transcends that which we engage with in this world. So in Judaism, it's kind of two religions in one, in the sense that you have the ritual, which can seem habitual to many people, but it's necessary because it keeps us productive. It keeps us accomplishing, achieving, making the world a better place. But you also have a dynamic of being. You have a dynamic of this identity, which is separate from our accomplishments and is very akin to that mindfulness state of being in the present. So Judaism is really that duality, revelation, revealing an inner truth as opposed to a realization. Because in revelation, we're actually doing something, we're achieving something, we're bringing a knowledge that's unknown to the world and making it known in the world, which is different to the Buddhist approach, subtly different, but different nonetheless, that in that realization is not really changing anything. It may be a conscious depth at which you can see things from a different perspective, but it doesn't necessarily change the world around you. So that, I would say, is the difference between the Jewish and Buddhist approach.
If you like that video, hit the subscribe button and notification bell below for hours of the best Jewish content online.